Hey guys, what's up? My name's The Cool Mike and welcome back with another video. But today I won't be playing a game, but I'm gonna be doing another Mega Bloks unboxing video. So this, if you guys have seen my vlog when I was in Canada, this was given to me by my cousin Albert. So we did a Christmas Christmas gift exchange thingy, and I asked for Mega Bloks and he wasn't able to find what I was looking for, but he managed to find this instead. I'm not sure if it's focusing on the camera. So there you go. There you go. So that's what it looks like. So wait, let me just... How do you do this? There you go. I cannot see if it's focusing on the camera because I'm blocking the screen. But that's what it looks like. And this is what it looks like from the back. So, that's what I'm getting. I'm gonna be doing a video of this today. So, that's what it looks like on the back. I'm not sure if you guys... where do you go? I'm not sure if you guys can see it, but that's what it looks like. That's the back, and this is the front. So yeah, I think this costs around $100 or $100 Canadian because he bought it in Canada. And I'm gonna be doing an unboxing video of this as well as a time lapse. So the next segment of this video is just gonna be a time lapse video with the music on, of me building this giant spaceship as well as the figurines. This is probably gonna take a while, so that without far ado, let's get started with the time lapse. Enjoy. Alright guys, so it is currently the next day. I hope you guys enjoyed that time lapse. It took me the entire day to actually build this this entire set. At first it looks easy, but it's not. This giant ship in particular took me hours to build it, especially how complicated the parts were. It was very hard to build. I would say it is not child friendly wise, because of how complicated the parts are, especially the wings, these parts. This part took me several hours to figure out how it works, and I had to make two of them. It was really hard,
Because one, they're very complicated to build. The parts are something I haven't tried before. And two, they were very fragile. So the moment you try pushing too much, because I have to push him from the, as you guys can see, they're connected with this. They're connected with this white, white thingy, this one. Once I tried pushing it inside this giant entire thing, it breaks. So they're very, fragile. And it is something not for kids. It is for kids, but it is something that cannot be played by kids, because kids, when they hold toys, this one is not gonna be as easy to hold, because this part is gonna fall off. It could fall off any minute if you hold it in the wrong way. So this is it. So this is the, I forgot it called, the Phyton Strike, the light Phyton. Oops. So this, it's called the Phyton Helia Strike. So that's what it's called, the Phyton Helia Strike. So I'm gonna be telling you guys giving my quick opinions and first impressions on this entire set. So this is the Phyton Helia Strike. It comes with a stand, by the way, which really is not, I think, yeah. So I'm gonna be doing a quick review. So this is the ship for the Phyton Helia Strike. I have no idea what it's called, because I never played Halo in my entire life. So it comes with it comes with four figures, two Spartans and two Promethean creatures. So without further ado, here's my review. So this is the ship, by the way. It's a combination of red and orange with a hint of gray. This is all print. So this is not stickers. So this is print, which is good, because putting stickers on this ship is not gonna be fun. As well as this one. So every print that you guys see, or every design that you guys see, are all print, and they're embedded in the actual piece, and they're not stickers, because putting stickers is not gonna be fun. So it comes with two openings. So if you build the ship, for some reason this part opens. I have no idea for what. I think a storage or something like that. So that part opens, and it opens, and there's a small space where you can put a bunch of stuff in, I think. Yeah. So this part is the pilot area. So if you open this, that's where the I put the Spartan Defender inside, and it's a tight squeeze. It is literally a tight squeeze. I literally have to push him inside that thing to fit. And I cannot even I could barely close it, because its head is still sticking out. And when I do, it hits his head. So that's a side part. Something disappointing about this piece. So I could not close it. I have no idea how to do that. So I have to push him through. And it barely fits, so it's a tight squeeze. You can literally fit him in there. It's just that you have to keep pushing him to the point that his legs are probably gonna break. But yeah, it's a very tight squeeze. I think they should have increased the space a little more, at least to make the soldier or the pilot fit, because it wouldn't even close because of the head. So this is the Spartan Orbital. I'm not gonna remove it, because removing it is not gonna be easy. But this is what it looks like. So that's the Spartan Defender, I mean. So this is the Spartan Defender. Not Orbital, because that's a different one. So this is the Spartan Defender. And he's the pilot, because he matches the color scheme of the ship. Red and orange. And he's carrying I don't have that pistol with him, because I put it in the box. Or what should I say, I put it in the other sets. But he has a beam rifle, a Delta beam rifle, if I'm not mistaken. So that's him. And the ship has basically as adjustable, what you call rifles on the sides, or some sort of weapon like clamps. So this inside here, and there's a side here. So I'm barely touching it because it's wiggling, and it might fall in a second. So it's the stands comes with it comes with this stand, which I would say too small, and it comes with this stand. I mean, I'm happy that they included this for elevation purposes, so it looks like it's flying. But still, the stands are a bit too small for the shape of this entire ship. So that's a bit concerning. They would have at least added those transparent white blocks. That would be more useful compared to this one, because they're too small. And it works, but every time you touch it, it wiggles. So that's quite disappointing. So now it also comes with this rocket launcher, or this torrent. So this is what it looks like. So it's a rocket launcher that rotates. I think you can rotate it. It's just that I can't do it with one hand. Yeah, I can't do it with one hand, but it rotates. So I might break it if I force it, but it can rotate 360. And I think actually I have an idea. Right, so this is the torrent, and it can rotate 360. As you guys could see, it's rotating right now. So it can rotate 360 from any angle. So that's cool. And it can also go up and down a little bit, because not too much. So it can go as high as this. I think you can rotate these two things up. So that's a plus. So you guys can rotate these two things up. You can put it like that. You can put it down, or you can put it up. I think it can also it cannot go left and right, but it can go up and down. And as well as this entire thing, you can either do that or do that. And then it can rotate. The whole thing can basically rotate easily. So you just have to be careful, because for a small object, it has a lot of parts, so that's crazy. Alright, so now time for the pieces. I already told you guys about the Defender, the Spartan Defender, which is this guy here. I'm not gonna remove him from the ship, because it's gonna be hard. But like I said, this is what he looks like, and he has a beam rifle. This is the next one, which is a Spartan Orbital, and it comes with a small, SMG, or a small machine gun with a print. So that's what the print looks like. I'm not sure if you guys could see it, but yeah, that's what the print looks like. And this is what the Spartan SMG, Spartan Orbital looks like. And it has prints all over. I like the print and the color, and of course it comes with a white SMG. This is a Phaeton crawler, I believe. Let me just double check, because it's called the Phaeton. It's not a Phaeton. It's a Promethean crawler. So it's a Promethean crawler. So it has, basically that's what it looks like. I'm not sure if you guys can see it, but that's what it looks like. Like an animal type of thing. So it's a Promethean crawler. You can move all legs, up and down. You cannot move them from left and right, I believe, but you can move it from up and down, and you could also move the head. Rotate the head. So that's cool. So that's the Promethean crawler. And then the next one is this one, this giant guy. This is called the Promethean Knight. So yeah, this is called the Promethean Knight. It comes with a gun on one hand and a blade on the other. So it's called a Promethean Knight, and it also has a Promethean, what you call, watcher on the back. So it's in the back. I don't know how I'm gonna do this. So let me just do this instead. So there's the watcher. So that's the Promethean watcher on the back. So basically, those are the pieces. So that's the crawler. So this one, so that's the crawler, the Promethean crawler, and then there's this is the Promethean watcher, which looks like this, basically, and it has its own stand, and you can actually put it in the back of the Promethean Knight. So that's it, that's him, or that's it. Inside the back of the Promethean Knight. And of course we have the Promethean Knight. So that's the Promethean Knight, and it looks like this. So this is it in comparison. I don't have the base plates yet, I haven't put it yet, but yeah. So that's the Promethean Knight. And of course the Spartan Defender with the beam rifle, the pilot that I'm using for this entire ship. Okay, so that's that. And of course the rocket launcher, or the torrent. So this is what it looks like in comparison. You can rotate it in different ways, so that you can go up and down, and you can rotate the entire thing 360. So that's cool. And of course, last but not the least, so that's the Spartan Defender and the Spartan Orbital. So this is what the Spartan Orbital looks like. Spartan Orbital, and this is what it looks like. So that's the Spartan, the Spartan Orbital. So with SMG, or a small machine gun with prints on it. So that's cool. Pretty much that's the entire set, all in all. That's the entire set. I would say my only comment about this entire set, let me just put them all together again, like this. I should have brought the stands with me, but that's okay. Oh god, this is so hard. This is one thing I hate about the, what you call, Promethean Knight. The back is too big. So big that it cannot even carry its own weight if you put it in the wrong way. There you go, that will have to do. Here and here. So my only comment about this, everything is perfect other than the ship. The ship has a lot of issues for me. One, the parts are too complicated to build. This one are not child friendly, because building them will require an adult assistance. I did not require an adult assistance because I've been building Lego for several years now, so I know how to build them. But it takes time. There were parts that were too confusing enough even with the manual. So, and another thing is, this cannot be easily held by a kid or a child, because the parts are too fragile, and if you hold it in the wrong way, it could break. Another thing, this one should have been a bigger space for the pilot. The space is too tight and too small. Oh yeah, speaking of this thing, if you look there, there's another print, which is the console for the pilot. So that's not a sticker, which is very cool. So that's a print for the pilot. I forgot to mention that. So the pilot cockpit should have been a little bigger, because seriously, every time I try to close it, it hits its head. I couldn't even push it anymore. That's as far as I can go with it, because I'm afraid that I'm gonna break it if I push it too much. So So that's another issue. And another issue is the part, what you call the things or the parts that are used to elevate the ship. So this one here, the base, and this one here, this one, there you go, that one. I would prefer the transparent white blocks to use it to elevate other than these parts, because it could fall off. It looks like it could fall off any minute. So that's that. But pretty much, that's the entire, the entire set, which is called the Promethean Heliostrike, I believe. The Phaeton. Why do I keep saying Promethean? The Phaeton Heliostrike. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this video. If you guys enjoyed it, be sure to leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe now if you haven't. And as always, if you guys want to watch other videos and other, time-lapse videos that I built in the past, I'll be leaving those videos in the description down below so you guys can go watch them. Other Lego or Mega Bloks videos that I did in the past, I will be leaving them in the description down below. So you guys could try to, you guys can go watch them. And as always, I will see you guys next time with another brand new video. This is The Cool Mike signing off. Goodbye.